good evening, or good morning, wherever you are on the earth. In this short video, I want to talk briefly about this confusion that people are holding on to. And that's the confusion of minding your own business. Now, I already explained in previous videos, in many of them, that this whole thing of privacy is a hoax. That in the spirit, there are no private spaces. It's just one open field. And evil spirits, they have almost all data of human beings stored in their archives. So that's why when people go to fortune tellers, they can find out a lot about you. Okay? So this whole privacy thing is a hoax. It's a fake security. I already explained that. I'm going into that again. I want to give a practical example now. Let's say now that in a community, like this community I'm in now, that there's this family living there, and the father of that family is targeted by some mobsters. But the guy has children, and the children are now suffering because of it. But those mobsters live in that same community. Now people say it's none of our business, so we don't mind, so we don't interfere. They want to be left alone. That's how the adult community is, that one day the father is killed. Who enabled it for it to happen? The community. The community knew that those mobsters lived over there, so the community, which are the vast majority of the population, should have made plain onto those mobsters, hey, you can have a conflict with someone, but you will resolve it in a civil manner. We don't tolerate those negative wills and those threats around here. And if you do continue, you'll be out of your house, and we'll make sure you won't be able to live here anymore. If the community had such an attitude, those mobs would have stopped. But now, because people want to mind their own business, want to be left alone, they now enable violence, and now someone has been murdered, children are fatherless, the wife now has become a widow, she doesn't know, she has no financial security anymore. So in this case, who's responsible for all of this? The community. Because the community willed it to happen, because their will was, we want to be left alone. You should never mind other people's business. Which other people's business. You are a community. Everything that happens in the community is community's business. Because you're the ones enabling it. Or you're the ones disabling it. So the community should have guarded that family. Okay, let's say now you are a believer, as you know this is going on. Let's say I'm living there. You know what I will do? If I pass by and I see that guy being threatened by the mobsters, the moment I see it happening, I will decree consequences of those mobsters. I will send confusion in their affairs. I will send confusion in their midst. And I will decree sour fire on them. And I will backfire every bad intent they had towards that man. I don't care if that man was killed or not. He's a father of children. His children need to be safe. And I would do that. And if those mobs would go to fortune tellers and they would become upset with me, let them come. Because there will be sanctions on them. And if they become homicidal, they'll be the ones departing from the earth, not me. Because I'm anointed by the Most High. That's how I operate. With me, there is no such thing as private lives, private wills. We can will whatever they will. I'm anointed. When I intervene, it is because it's necessary to intervene. I don't just go out and intervene just like that. When I intervene, it's serious. And consequences will happen for those that are in agreement with evil. So better hope I will not have to intervene, because if I have to intervene, well, and you are in agreement with evil, you are in very big trouble. Okay? No evil can be at ease in my presence. Okay? Nobody can will for free around me. That's how I operate. But what does pagan Christianity teach you? No, you need to mind your own business, go to your job, pay your rent, come to church every Sunday and leave people alone so people can will whatever they will, because it's their life and all of that. That's not what scripture is saying. Scripture said the saints will judge the world in the here and now. Okay? Psalms 149, judgment has been given unto the saints. So we execute judgment in the here and now. Supernaturally. Not just on our own behalf, because that's a trick. Too often believers are so focused on fixing everything in their circumstances. No, you don't fix things in your circumstances. You walk by faith and things will work out for you. I'm not pointing a finger at you. I also sometimes fall into this trick of having to fix things. No. You walk by faith and you will see things work out. Okay? But about this minding your own business BS. So you mean to tell me that if there's harm in a community, people will permit it to happen, they will enable it to happen just because they are one that want to have relief? Don't you see how wicked this is? It gets worse. Let's say now the European Union comes with a new directive or new regulation and all the EU member states need to comply. And the Netherlands is part of the European Union, so the Dutch government complies. Now, those same people that allowed murder to take place in their community because they want to be left alone, the same people now stand up and say, this is our life, we can't stand this. What about what we want? Hold on a minute. So when some politicians were often devil worshippers in Brussels, come with some decree. You guys have a will against it, want to defend yourself and your rights and all of that. But what about the rights of those in the community which are vulnerable that you allowed bad to happen to? Oh, so it's only important when the self is involved. You see how wicked this mind your own business attitude is? People use this as an excuse not to do what's right. Now, I'm not saying you should just intervene in every situation, no. But as a community, you are responsible for what you enable or disable. And I, being anointed by the Most High, I operate in righteous judgment, and when it's necessary, I'll intervene and things will go very wrong if you're involved in evil. That's how it is. Just like Elijah did, just like Moses did, just like the prophets all did, just like the apostles in the New Testament did in the first century. That's how it goes. That's how I do. I don't do willing what people will. I don't do that. No, if you're wrong and you persist in it, you're dealt with, period. You live on the jurisdiction of Christ, who's Lord of heaven, on earth, of heaven and earth. Deal with it. So I'm in agreement with him. And after agreement and attack on me, will face retaliation by him directly. Oh, and you don't want that. I'm not threatening you, I'm just pointing out as it is. Come on now. So you mean to tell me folks will enable evildoers just so they are left alone? Look, if you're in a cafe and people enter in with guns, let's say you have four men entering with guns and there are only like 20 people there, and those people, and let's say you're only like five people there and children, okay, then I can understand you just comply, just allow things to happen, because what can you do? But even then you can do something. But now you have a community of thousands of people, sometimes hundreds of thousands, even a million people, and you have all these violence going on. People just allow it to happen because they want to be left alone. So their will to be relieved is more important than the safety of them as a community? What? You know what? I won't say bother, but you know what terrifies me? I'm not in fear, but you know what terrifies me, what really shocks me, is when people that claim to follow Christ follow this garbage of permitting evil to happen or give people the right to be evil because they have a free will. What's that? Look, I don't make this video to complain. I made this video to make you alert so that you will see and see this BS, this evil people are doing by permitting people to will whatever they will. You're on the Christ jurisdiction, everywhere you are, in heaven and on earth. He has anointed people like me to execute righteous judgment. So if you encounter them, you better deal with them in the right manner. Because if you don't, if you ignore them, get fed up with them, whatever, sanctions on you, repercussions, wherever you are. Whether you're in your own home, in your bedroom, in your kitchen, where, or in the pub, wherever you are, sanctions on you. That's how it is. I mean, so when I operate in righteous judgment, people say, mind your own business, their life, blah, blah, blah. Okay. But they will tolerate oppressive regimes killing people, committing genocide. They will tolerate that, but they won't tolerate someone agreeing with Christ and operating in righteous judgment to guard safety in the human community. They won't tolerate that. What? Don't you see how effed up this is? Well, I just want to point that out to you. I don't do that. I really don't do that. I agree with Christ. It's time for you to do that also and enforce righteous judgment in your environment. And you'll see what the changes will happen. Not everyone will enjoy the changes, but that's their problem under Christ's jurisdiction. If they have a problem with you operating righteous judgment, they have to put that up with him. And well, he's waiting for them, but well, they know they're finished then. Anyway, I agree with Christ and be at peace.